Hi. Okay, everybody, this is what we're going to do. I asked my page, yes, you guys, a couple days ago, what it is that you wanted me to record. Gosh, I look so tired. I've been wanting to know what it is that Spirit wants me to do next. I haven't been sleeping. My mind's just been going like crazy. I know that there's something that I'm supposed to be doing, and yet I didn't know what it was. I knew that I was supposed to be making a move of some sort, travel. I kept getting, there's travel in your to do with your path, and yet I thought, you know, where am I going? You know, and I didn't go to Wisconsin for Dark Songs. I had no plans on going anywhere, but so I asked the page. I said to you, what is it that you would like to see me do, because I know that something to do with my spiritual work has to do with the videos, because I get such a response to the videos, you know, when I'm out, and it seems that I get the most connection to Spirit when I'm outside, when I'm in nature, when I'm moving, when I'm traveling, when I'm in Sedona, wherever, and I'm recording, and I do my readings, and so much comes to me, and I don't even have to necessarily be doing the readings, just being out, I get information from Spirit. So I asked on the page the other day, what it is that you would like me to talk about? Like, what should I do? I'm kind of like running out of options here, and yet I know I'm supposed to be doing something else. And one of my friends said, guides, speak about guides. And I thought, ugh, I don't hear my guides. I don't see my guides. I don't know any guides' names. I'm different than a lot of other people. Everybody has different gifts. I have friends that are mediums that speak to the dead. I have friends that speak to animals. I have friends that are able to see spirit. My friend Ryan, he's able to see, you know, so much more, our oversouls and all of our guides around us. And, you know, I don't see any of that. And I say, you know, when is that coming for me? You know, I want my gifts to expand. I know that I'm guided, but I don't know who is guiding me. I have heard guides speak to me. I have twice seen, I saw my Native American guide, a woman, an older woman, one time when I first awoken. I have heard and seen Archangel Michael, or what the representation of Archangel Michael. And I know that he is the one. I always get very emotional because he's the one who's with me most. So maybe he's my guide. And remember when I was in Sedona, I made a comment when I was doing a video. He gets to me, you know, Archangel Michael. When I was in Sedona, I said that I wanted my guides, whoever these guides were, to step out and leave me alone, because I wasn't sure who was guiding me, and I didn't like that. I knew that Archangel Michael I feel safe with, and I know that I'm led in a way, when I'm with him, I'm safe. And so I wanted all the other guides to step out and leave me alone, and just to have the Archangel come forward that was working with me. And it was Archangel Jeremiah that came out in a card, and I thought, it's not him, you know. I feel like it's Archangel Michael. And then for a while, I was blocked. Like, I felt like I just wasn't hearing or seeing. And then the other day, I said to myself, okay, you know, I don't know what I'm doing, you know. Bring my guides back. You know, I asked them to step out, and so I'm asking them to come back. I don't know who they are, but I do know that I am guided. I'm just guided by Spirit. I know that Spirit is guiding me, leading me. It led me from California to Wisconsin. It led me from Wisconsin to Sedona. It led me back from Sedona to here, even though I didn't want to come back to California. And now, you know, I listen to my guidance very, very clearly. I ask again and again and again to make sure that what I'm hearing is what I'm supposed to be hearing, and that I'm not being confused. You know, people have said to me, you know, Sherry, are you very specific that you're only, because there are other I don't know what you want to call them. I don't even know what I want to call them or what I feel about them. Other entities, other spirit beings that have crossed over that, you know, sometimes we have joy guides and they kind of play with us and they mess around with us. And sometimes there's other, when we channel, because I know I channel messages from Spirit, you got to be very careful that when you're channeling from the light, also from somebody who is truly guiding you, that spiritually guiding you from the Creator. So I get specific and I say, okay, all beings, and I don't care who they are. I don't care if they're aliens. I don't care if they're spirit creatures. They're all spirit creatures to me. So I will say, any beings of love and light that are guiding me in my highest good, come forward and help me. So to sit here and discuss with you, how do you know who your guides are, or what your guides' names are, or how do you call upon them? I don't know, because I don't know myself. Like I said, in my I have prophetic dreams, and my dreams guide me. I pay almost the most attention to my dreams. The second most attention I pay is to what I hear on the radio, literally through songs, because music is used by spirit as a medium for me. Songs are very important. Music is very important to me. It guides me. The words, I will hear certain words, and I know when I'm being spoken to. I know who's speaking to me, and I follow that. So I've been asking again and again for spirit, what is my next move? What am I supposed to do? Where am I supposed to go? And I kept getting, you're going to be traveling. And I thought, I still don't understand, And then my friend, when she was asking me, she kept saying about guides, and I said, I don't really know them. I don't know who they are. And she said, well, and she kept kind of talking about it. And then I was speaking to a friend, a Facebook friend, KT, and we haven't really talked a lot, but I put a post out on my page, and I said, is there anybody on my page that is able to read somebody from a picture? Because I know people have that gift as well. And he answered. And I said, really? You? And I was a little skeptical. And I thought, really? And I said, why didn't I know that about you? And he said, I don't know. I told you when I first met you. And I thought, well, that was eons ago. And, I don't really pay attention to men. Not that I don't pay attention. I mean, I keep kind of a barrier up between me and men. I just do. It's just my policy. So I'm in a very committed soul relationship with somebody that you guys all don't know who it is. And it doesn't matter. It's nobody's business. But I am, and so my heart's there, and so I keep men at a distance. So anyway, I decide that, okay, I'm going to talk to him, and I go to him privately, and I start to speak, because I don't talk to men privately on my page unless it has to do with my spiritual work. That's another number one rule, so all you people know that. And so I start to speak to him, and I said, all right, I'm going to give you this picture, but I want to know that I can trust you, that, y'all want these pictures deleted because this is very private and blah, blah, blah. So we start to speak, and I realize that this man is incredibly gifted. He's very, very connected. I met one other woman that was this way when my path first began, probably 5 years ago, and she's amazing. She's a third generation shaman, and we had a little bit of a falling out, and so I kept trying to reach out over the years to see if that she would, I'd show her that my path has expanded, and all the things that she had showed me had happened, and would she consider swapping readings? I've read for her before as well, but she was really the only one I trusted that had this gift, that could see the future of things that were coming for me, that I was seeing them in ways that spirit would speak to me. I would get messages and signs, and yet to have somebody else validate that I trusted was really important to me, but she never would. She wouldn't. So as I'm speaking to my friend last night, I realized that he is the same. He said that he's the third generation. He says he doesn't feel he's as connected as his grandparents and his parents, and I'm like, no, you are very connected. The things that he was telling me were just dead right on, basically confirming what I was already given. So we started to work, and he was telling me about, that I needed to move and I needed to go, and I thought, no, I'm not on this quest, and I thought, no, I'm not going to do this. And so I talked to my best friend, Julie, last night about it, and she said, you've done it before. And I said, you need to come with me. And she goes, no, you've done it. You've gone to Wisconsin. You can get up and do this. And I thought, no, I'm not doing this by myself. I'm not going to go on this quest. I don't even know where I'm going. And so I went to sleep last night, and I had three dreams, and all very prophetic. And one of them, in the dream, I was somewhere. I don't know quite yet where I was, but I was filming. I was videotaping with my camera, my cell phone, which is going off like crazy. And I was saying, I was videotaping. I was inside of a place that had like an altar or a church that was inside another building. And it was very intricate and carved. And for some reason, my friend and I were discussing Northern California last night. He was seeing this windy road. And I kept saying, gosh, I keep being pulled to Northern California myself. I wanted to do that with somebody else. I wanted to go there with my twin, and it never happened. And he was seeing this. And I said, that sounds like Northern California. And I'm getting prickles. So this is confirmation for me, which is very cool because I was a little nervous about where I'm heading. And so in this dream last night, what I was videotaping, for some reason when I was looking at it, and I woke up this morning and I thought to myself, I think that's Hearst Castle. Now, I don't know if they do, but I'm pretty certain that he would have had a church inside of his in his castle. He has pools, he has everything, you know? So I think basically what it was just telling me is I'm heading in that direction. And the fact that I was videotaping a church, I'm not into churches. I don't like churches. They kind of creep me out. I've stayed away from them, you know, pretty much because of my upbringing, you know, just a personal thing, but my church is outside. So I think more what it was telling me was that I'm going to be videotaping and it's going to be to do with my work and it's to do with spirituality. So I woke up this morning and, all of this stuff was going through my head. And of course I always have music going. I've got music going right now because I get many of my messages through that. So I go in, I'm in the shower and I put on iHeartRadio, stick it up. I don't know who it is, Mario Lopez, that's the station I listen to, and a song's going, and the first song that comes on is Eminem, and he's singing, what is that song, You Only Got One Shot, you know, and it's basically, he's talking about himself as a rapper, and how he's nervous, you know, but he's going to get up there, and he talks about how the guy, his heart's beating, and he's going to get up there, and he's going to throw out the song, and he's going to do it, and you've only got one shot, and if you only had one shot, would you take it, would you jump, and I thought, I've got one shot. And I know where I'm going. I know what my quest is, what I'm looking for, but I'm nervous about it. And I thought to myself, yes. And this song was like completely pumping me up. I'm washing my hair and I'm thinking, I can do this. I've done it before. I can do this. And then the next song that came on was Counting Stars, One Republic. It's very, very important to me, that song. It started in February. And it's a message to me. And one of the lines is, in your face is flashing signs. Seek it out and you shall find. Gosh, I'm getting emotional again. And so it's telling me that I'm supposed to do this. So what I'm doing here right now with you today, people, is this is the first. I'm going to leave tomorrow. Tomorrow afternoon, or I might leave Thursday at the latest. I'm not certain. But I'm going to head up the coast, up the Northern California coast. And I'm going to be stepping in. I'm going to bring my video camera. I'm going to be bringing my computer. And I'm going to be recording as I go along. I don't know what I'm doing. What I'm going to do is, because of my friend saying guides, I'm going to let spirit guide me. And they guide me through music. So as I'm driving, I'm going to be listening in the car about where I'm meant to go. I'll also pay attention to Facebook and things that popped up. I've just saw Mount Baldy, and I don't know. And I was told, and then another got a message. I'll show you this. I picked up my smoothie this morning, and it says, "Grab your brain mittens." Mittens. So I thought to myself, I'm going to the snow. So I went and I started to get this is what I do. I went and got I bought these boots because I thought I was moving to Wisconsin last year, and they're snow boots. And I got my winter coat out, and I got mittens. And grab your brain mittens. Mittens are something that covers your hands. Your hands are how you feel your way. You don't want if you don't want to touch something that's too cold, you'll put mittens on. So I'm going to go in the snow. It means something else too because it says grab your brain mittens. So take your brain with you. I'll have to think about that. I'm going to think about that. But I'm just here to tell you guys, this is the first. They're going to be coming. And I'm going to allow my guides, whoever they are, the ones that come from the Creator, all in light and love, I want them to guide me. And I'm going to listen to where they want to send me. And I'm going to follow. And this is my quest. And I don't know, but wherever I end up, I'm meant to be there. And I'm going to take a week, probably. That's what my plan is right now, is a week. I might take a little longer, but a week at this time. And I'm on a quest, and so I'm listening to music. I'm going to work with my friend KT because I trust him fully, and I'm going to allow spirit to take me where we need to go. And so you guys tune in and be prepared for anything. And the song that's on right now, White Knuckles, Sweaty Palms from Holding On Too Tight, So I'm Gonna Let Go. So I've been trying to control my life, and I can't control my life. I've realized that spirit is guiding me, and so I'm gonna let go, and I'm going to let spirit guide me to where I'm meant to go and to see what I'm meant to see and share what I'm meant to share with you guys. So that's it. So here's our first go. Day one. We'll talk soon. Blessings.